Hello. Can you hear me? Echo, echo, echo. It's pretty cool.
I don't know if this is picking up on camera or not, but see speckles in the sand. Looks like some type of metal, maybe some gold or silver. It was somewhere on these rocks where it's clear as day, some silver that you can peel off the rock. Well, I did earlier, but yeah, this like it went onto the rock and now the rock absorbed it into itself and definitely looks like some silver on here, so it's pretty cool. What I'm talking about, and for it to be this small, it has some density to it. So
I just made I don't have a name for it yet. I'm not sure what to call it, but here's the body, the head, the hat, or maybe, you know, whatever you want, whatever your imagination says it is. But yeah, if you got a name for it, let me know what the name could be. His angle from the side, angle from the other side. If you're ever out on a hike or trail or walk or something, then you ran out of water for some reason. You don't have water. Getting thirsty, or maybe you just need to wash your face or something. So, as you can see, the water stream, has a good little bit of run to it. At least 500 feet, I would say. This is supposed to be like a river or a full blown out stream, but sense of the current state of the land, you know, this is what we have to work with. So if you want to drink some of this water, you want to get a good guesstimation or synopsis of what's at the top, what's at the start, beginning of the water, and then come down to a spot like this where you can see it looks pretty clear. Only thing that doesn't look clear is the color from the rocks that is, you know, making it look a little bit yellow. So if you have like a bottle or something, or if you're just thirsty, you know, just cup in your hands. And you have to have good running water. You can't have standing still, still water. It has to be moving, good chi to it, a good current flowing through it. If you know, that's how you gotta do it. And you know, other than that, get you a little ball or something. Hello down there! So here, we're like at Sabino Canyon, Sabino Park, something of that nature. This is a very long trail. Like it goes, I don't know, it just keeps going and going and going. And then the water was way too high to cross and I just stopped. Then I tried to go that way, and then when I got probably about a mile up that road right there, it just kept going and going. They said like it's like another 4 more miles to get to the 7 falls or something like that. It's not too terribly hot. I'll probably say it's mid 90s or so. It was cooler when I started. But yeah, you know, I've probably seen close to 100 people out today. You know, kids, you know, we're out here too. They're out here playing in the creek. It's kind of dirty in some spots. Some spots is cleaner. But yeah, if you're ever in Tucson, looking for somewhere to hike for about a couple hours, if you want to conserve your energy and hike all the way to the 7 falls, you do that. It pretty sure you'll have a good old time, and you'll definitely shed 10 pounds that day. So yeah, I'm about ready to get something to eat. I've had my water, the water from the creek, and the water, you know, that I bought from the store. Some grapes and then some crackers. But yeah, I guess they can land a helicopter here if need be, and don't know how to get to someone if they're actually in a tough spot. But last but not least, I'm gonna try to walk up here. Can't really see it. But I pass it, and then I went back here, and then I'm gonna go back up here. So all in all, I probably walked at least 5 miles so far, at least. Because I came out here, I would say 3 hours ago. But yeah. So someone has some rocks there for me. I mean, it come up here. So I climb up here. You can't, there's no doors over here. It's got these two things. So, not sure what's going on here. Maybe some type of water well or something. But, yeah. You can see pretty far up here. Got a nice breeze. You see all the way to the mountaintops, down in the valley where the city is. Yep. You can probably see. I was told over here, those mountains are like 60 miles away or something. I mean, you can probably see close to 100 miles, you know, out. So, you see a very, very, very far way. And just imagine if you go up to the mountaintops, or that mountaintop, where nothing's blocking you, you can probably, I know for a fact, you can see Mexico from here. But yeah, I think I'm ready to go get something to eat now. The hardest part is me trying to get down here. Right here we have a Centennial Mountain, or a mountain. If I zoom in, you can see the A right there on top at the capstone of the so-called mountain. To me, it looks like a pyramid, one big pyramid. The capstone is said to be about 2,100 feet. Looks very nice up there. Next time I come back here, I will have to go up there to that capstone and see what's really going on up there. But yeah, I don't think I'm gonna be getting into it today. But yeah, Centennial Mountain, A Mountain, whatever, big giant pyramid is what I'm gonna call it. Pyramid in Tucson. There's probably other various pyramids here. Another thing I noticed about Tucson is the rail cars, and this is probably for all rail cars across the world, whatever. But the rail cars seems to be working off of atmospheric electricity, because they have these lines, right? You know, we all seen the lines in the, you know, different shows where they have in San Francisco or whoever has rail cars. And these lines are just maybe a little bit of aluminum and metal, or I'm not sure what type of metal these are for the lines, but the power, there's no power source coming to these lines that I see. There may be some somewhere at the start or the end, but I don't see that anywhere to generate the lines. But it seems like they're using electricity from the air, and then you have the insulated parts that, you know, help suspend the parts, and then on top of the rail car, you know, you have your conductor to conductor, whatever terminology you want to use, and then that's how the rail cars work, because the rail cars are admittedly electric. But yeah, streetcar, rail car, tram, whatever you want to call it. Down here in Arizona at the campus, the U of A, whatever, just walking around, just seeing what they got to offer, what the facilities look like, and every that. Now I'm walking, and I see one of my favorite fruits there is. Limes. Good old-fashioned limes. I'm going to take one. Put this in like a guacamole or something. I mean, they got trees and trees. Look at these big things. Look at them. Look at this big. I guess these are limes. These things are humongous. Humongous. But Tucson was very nice. Free public transportation for right now. They also have, you know, the mountains, they have the desert, they have all of it. Very good place to visit. A lot of history here. Pretty nice people. And yeah, you should definitely come check it out sometime.